I was born in 1956 in the midst of the baby boom, 4 years before Harold Macmillan's Winds of Change speech, which ushered in the dismantling of empire, though the winds of change were already very much in evidence. It was the year Britain's questionable moral authority and military might were laid bare by the fiasco of the Suez Canal, while in Hungary the Soviets were brutally suppressing a popular uprising. In the same year, rock and roll took off, and the social and cultural hierarchies of post-war Britain began to fracture. 1956 has since been voted the best year in which to be born, with the children of the 1950s the most content of any subsequent generation. Life for the vast majority on our planet has improved. Before COVID stalled progress, we had never been better off. This is mainly because India and China are powering out of poverty and the extremes of misery across the poor world are at an all-time low. Since 2000, more than 1 billion people have gained access to energy, more than 90% of girls are now in primary school, deaths from malaria, a huge killer of children, are falling, and thanks to Bill Gates, polio is heading for eradication. Deaths from HIV/AIDS have reduced by 50%, 90% of people now have access to clean water, and greenhouse gas emissions decreased by 13% in the developed world between 1990 and 2018. Since 2014, deaths from terrorism have fallen by 20%. If education, health, cleanliness, and security are the keys to liberty, especially for women, then we are at an all-time high. In 1815, 1 person in 100 lived in a democracy. Now half the world has that privilege, and more women ran for office in 2018 than in any previous year in human history. Between 1988 and 2008, the world signed 650 peace agreements. Negotiations during those 20 years brought more conflicts to a close than in the previous 200. But over the past decade, any illusions that the peace dividend from the end of the Cold War could be realised and a new era of tranquility ushered in have been blown away.